Hi there, SharePoint enthusiasts. Today I want to show you an open source PowerShell module for SharePoint developers and administrators. It's maintained and developed by a wonderful community. PnP PowerShell is a powerful tool that can perform a wide range of tasks, from creating SharePoint sites to updating SharePoint list items. Besides performing many of the tasks that the official SharePoint Online Management shell can do, it can also cover many low-level SharePoint tasks, as well as a ton of other tasks exposed through Graph API. For example, you have some useful commands for working with Microsoft Teams, Planner, and the Power Platform. PnP PowerShell has several versions, and I use them all, depending on the situation. The legacy version supports PowerShell Server and doesn't require the Azure App registration. I use this version even though it's considered obsolete. The more modern PnP PowerShell version has two options. The older version, 1.12, supports PowerShell 3 and 5, as well as PowerShell ISE. The latest version only works with PowerShell 7 or later, but it's cross-platform, meaning it can run from a Linux-based system. So what can you use this module for? Well, here are the most frequent tasks I use it for. Create SharePoint sites, add or remove site administrators, update site navigation, provision lists, libraries, pages, and web parts, update document metadata, and generate custom reports. And these are just some of its capabilities. You can visit the official site for the full list. Now let's launch PowerShell 7, which is compatible with the latest PnP version. I'll install the module by running this command. I usually use the scope current user switch to install PowerShell modules. When you use the switch, it doesn't require administrator privileges. Now that the module is installed, let's register an Azure App registration, which you need to work with the latest version of the PnP PowerShell. This step requires a global administrator role to accept the permission request. I'll run this command to register a new app registration. Make sure to specify your SharePoint domain. You'll be asked to consent to the default set of permissions. You might want to write down the client ID for your new application. Now let's connect to SharePoint Online using this command. Use your domain and your client ID. Okay, let's create a sample SharePoint site using this script. And here is the result. Next, let's assign a SharePoint administrator to the newly created site. You can also create a document library and upload a document using these two commands. This is the way to add links to the navigation. And finally, this is how you can get a report on all SharePoint sites in your tenant. These are just a few out of the hundreds of commands that are available. PnP PowerShell has several authentication methods. Use the one that works for you. And now you know how to use PnP PowerShell, one of the most powerful tools in the SharePoint Administrator's Toolkit.